This film is dedicated to Ricky Matthew Rubin, an extraordinary collie and an even more extraordinary buddy. Ricky first came into our lives on October 30th, 2003. He was 8 months old, and it's hard to imagine that he came here on a trial. And as we look back, we begin to realize that it was probably Ricky that was trying us out and not vice versa. It's almost impossible to put into words the impact that Ricky has had on all of our lives. Life just wouldn't have been the same without him. And that impact continues to this day. I remember when he first came to us, one of the things I noticed almost immediately about him was his high level of intellectualization of just about everything that was going on around him. He would approach the doorway of a bedroom and look left, look right, think about whether or not he wished to enter, and then he would decide. He would either come in or not. And it's this level of intelligence that Ricky has that enables the kind of communication that we have with him, which serves as the foundation for the overall relationship that we have.
Sunset sky. Make my hands respect the things that you have made. Show me the way. Show me.
What's so special about Ricky?
Wow, it's a little too broad of a question because it's, I don't know where to begin.
Well, start anywhere you want.
I think that his soul is where you have to start with. And, when you think about somebody that is, or a creature that is as pure and loving and just his main priority in life is to be with us and would defend us with his life, but at the same time be just the sweetest guy there ever is and ever will be. That's what makes him so special. I can't remember my life before him at this point. And And, you know, he's just the best.
How many names for him can you rattle off?
Riccarino, Rickster, Ricky Matthew, Rubin, Gandhi, Collie Boy, Frisky Boy, Hope, Nikki. Wow, and I'm brain freezing right now because there's the snow cone. There's another 40. I think I could probably come up with it.
What? What's going on? What are you saying? What are you saying? Oh, really, huh? You think so? You know what's going to happen. What? What? Are you licking yourself? Rick? You know what's going to happen? If you do that? Do you want attention? Do you want to have a conversation? Well, okay. All right. What else? Yeah. Did you go there with Mommy? Did you? You would Mommy go to the hardware store today? Yeah? Did you go too? You did? Did you go too? To the store? Mommy left you home? By yourself? She left you home by yourself? What'd you do? Did you scare any animals? Were there any bad guys? Did you bark at them? You did, huh? Yeah. Okay. Are you a good boy? Are you a good boy?
What? What, Rick? What? What? What, Rick? What, buddy? What, Ricky? What?
For the first few years of Ricky's tenure with us, we pondered on almost a daily basis the question of whether or not he was a lushy mush or a mushy lush. This is a question that has stimulated us intellectually for quite some time. We eventually came to the conclusion that he was a lushy mush, because the contrary concept of a mushy lush conjured up in our minds that of an obese drunk. So it became obvious to us that lushy mush was the appropriate conclusion. Now, what's interesting is that in 2005, Stephen Hawking, of great worldwide fame, weighed in on this subject. He said as follows, "Black holes aside, my interest has always lied in the intricacies of the elegant logic that defies the primordial contrast between Mushy Lushes and their counterparts, Lushy Mushes. It is my considered opinion that this will remain a philosophical conundrum for generations to come. Angelina Jolie, in the following year, said, quote, "If he were human, I'd adopt him." And finally, it was none other than Pope Benedict XVI himself that finally said of Ricky, and this is a quote, "Ipsum quantis midi valorum, OMG, WTF, now this is a collie."
See, a mushy lush or a lushy mush? He's a lushy mush.
Why is he a lushy mush?
Because his big coat comes to mind first when I think of it. And
right.
The mush, because you can go up and nuzzle him up and just do your usual molestation.
Just so gentle with the, giving me the paw.
Uh-huh.
How about Ricky sipping a Bloody Mary? Picture him doing that. If he likes the tomatoes. They're not coming off the fork. Now you want my food bone.
What do you want, buddy? What do you want, Rick? What do you want? No, what? You want a cracker? Ricky?
What does Ricky want?
A cracker?
Or water?
Cheese? You want cheese and crackers, buddy? You want cheese and crackers? Yeah? Do you like that? What do you like better, the cheese or the cracker? What do you like better?
Hey, Rick, did we also go on a nice walk today? Huh? Did Mommy and Rick go on a nice walk? We went on a long walk today.
Is Ricky good with security?
Ricky is good with security. I would say that he would outperform any of the best security alarms out there on the market right now. I don't know that anybody could come within the 19 on the mailbox without getting hassled. Let's put it this way. I don't know how many break-ins he's had to deter, but if, in his mind, anything that has a package with it, a pizza box with it, Chinese food, or anybody that just has the gall to come on the yard, in his mind is a break-in attempt. So over the years, there has to have been thousands, I guess, at this point, and he is undefeated. Locks can be clipped, windows can be broken, but Ricky will not be deterred, and he is proof positive the number one security guy on the planet.
Well, honey, today's our anniversary, and a package arrived.
I know.
Why don't you show us the package? It was from Jimmy and Olga.
Here it is.
And it was delivered by the UPS. And what's this?
Well, it seems that Ricky doesn't like the UPS man too much. And when the gentleman had left and let 3 minutes go by, and I opened the door to retrieve the package, Ricky greeted the package with his teeth.
So he bit the package.
And he bit the package.
You know why?
It came from a bad man.
Well, he's also director of Homeland Security.
And he took care of that.
And he did his job.
He just did his job. Somebody's got to do it.
What's going on, Rick? What's going on? Who's here? Who's here, buddy? Who's here? They're gonna cut the grass. Rick! It's a collie boy! What is it?
It's like a deer jerky or something.
Baked deer droppings?
No.
Oh, yeah, that's better. You're out of this light is good now.
Oh, yeah. Whoop. There you go. There you go.
Happy Hanukkah. Merry Christmas, Rick.
Oh, yeah, that's
yummy.
Good. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Merry Christmas, Ricky.
Is that good?
He felt bad about himself. He thought nobody thought.
Hey, buddy. Ricky. Merry Christmas.
You're welcome, buddy.
Happy Hanukkah.
He's looking. Oh, and he's kissing. Oh, this I'll have forever. Yes, he kisses I'll have forever. Yeah. What are you saying? Huh? What are you saying? Huh? Oh. I love you. I love you. Yeah. You saying I love you back?
Good day today, Ricky? Are you glad we all came and had a party together?
Yes, buddy. Yes, Ricky?
What's that little girl bark?
Well, Ricky is a very sweet boy. And I was a little scared of him when I first met him because I wasn't really much of a dog person at that point, although I grew up with dogs my whole life. And, but he is just such a kind-hearted, loving collie boy that I was able to get over my fears and have a nice little relationship with him.
What do you think it is about him that makes him different from other animals? Seriously, why is he different?
I think Ricky's different because he's very intelligent and he can engage in a conversation that most animals can't do that.
Well, that's true. When you spend time with him, what is it about him that you notice the most?
What I notice the most about Ricky is that he is very thoughtful, and I think one of my favorite times with him was when I stayed homesick here in Connecticut, and the two of us had a nice day, and he stayed in the bed with me, guarding the house all day long, and we were very cozy. And then one other time in the city, he stayed, Scott wasn't there, so maybe I stayed home again, and he was on the bed with me, and I put the covers over him like a blanket, and he was just like a big baby in the bed with me.
America's freshest lineup is here at your Tri-State Ford dealer. See
how
Ford
meets Toyota
and EPA-rated fuel economy in every segment we compete. And with EcoBoost technology that delivers efficient power, Ford has you covered at the pump. So get to your Tri-State Ford dealer today and see why Ford is America's best.
What is it to you that's so special about Ricky?
Personality.
Right.
And he's absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm. What is it about his personality?
Well, I get a really nice warm welcome when I come. So, and I love all animals, so Ricky's just family.
Look at you, mister. Come on. Let's go. Come on, mister. Come on, mister. Look at you. Come on. Come on. Go, Ricky. Come on. Hey, mister. Come on, mister. Come on. Come on. Let go. Let go. Come on, Rick. Let go, buddy. Come on. Let's go.
Ricky is special because he is my everyday buddy who I wake up to, I feed, I love, and he gives back 110% of all of that in his beauty, his kindness, his sweetness, his smell, his everything.
What do you find to be particularly unique about him?
He is so intelligent and gets everything to the point where he gets things that some people don't get. The nuances, the tempo, the just whatever's going on that he picks up on. That, as I said, some people don't do. I love him infinity, forever and ever. And it's because he is who he is. And his being is so special that it's indescribable.
Is there anything in particular that you would want to say about him for the purposes of this documentary?
He is an addition to this world, and the people that come across him who open up, who are amenable to understanding who he is, just get it. He means everything to me. He is 19 Pine Wood Road, and without him at 19 Pine Wood Road, there would be no 19 Pine Wood Road.
River flows surely to the sea.